reverse and eastward flowing reverse. Am I audible? Am I audible? Okay, westward flowing reverse, thank you. And eastward flowing reverse. Generally, as the peninsular reverse, all such rivers, they are in a mature stage. All the peninsular rivers, they are in their mature stage. Why? Because they are generally originates from the flat tableland structures of a plateaus. They are neither originates as equal to the Himalayas from the high altitudinal areas. So because of the plateau structure, they are generally having as a less velocity, less volume of water and less velocity of water. They are at their mature stage. All the peninsular rivers at their mature stage. Second feature of a peninsular rivers are peninsular rivers, they widen, they generally as flowing through the widened valleys. Peninsular rivers, they generally flow through the wide valleys, except Narmada and Tapi. Third feature of peninsular rivers, except Narmada and Tapi, all the rivers mix as the deltas. Except Narmada and Tapi, Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari, and Mahanadi, they generally forms the deltas. All such rivers, they forms the deltas. So westward flowing rivers and eastward flowing rivers. Westward flowing rivers and eastward flowing rivers. Westward means Narmada and Tapi, which are flowing towards the west. They originates from the central India or eastern side towards the west. They flow towards the west. Narmada and Tapi. Kaveri in Tamil Nadu, Krishna in Andhra Pradesh, Godavari in Andhra Pradesh, and Mahanadi in Odisha. In Odisha, these four rivers, they generally flows towards the eastward side. They originate from the west and flows towards the east. They flows towards the east. Now, here we will discuss about the all such rivers in detail. In which of us as a Narmada River. The river Narmada originates from Amarkantak Hills of Madhya Pradesh. Now it's presently, these are in a border of Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. Amarkantak Hills. Narmada originates from Amarkantak Hills in Madhya Pradesh and flows westward through a rift valley. It flows westward through a rift valley between the Vindhya range and Satpura range. So Narmada, it flows in between of a Vindhya range and Satpura range. In between of Vindhya range and Satpura range. Clear? The Vindhya range and Satpura range. The total length of a Narmada is 1,078 kilometers. 1,078 kilometers. Yes, Yug.
सर आवाज सर बीच में ना कट जाती है सर, वीडियो नहीं आती आपकी.
It may be as a due to the poor network conditions, due to the cloudy weather conditions. So let's continue. 1078 kilometers long Narmada River originates from Amarkantak and fall in Arabian Sea. It fall in Arabian Sea. The river Narmada forms the Narmada River इट फॉर्म्स द धुआंधर फॉल्स DHUANDHAR. It's at Jabalpur. At Jabalpur, Jabalpur, Narmada forms the waterfall. You put it your hand down. Narmada forms the waterfall at Dhuandhar, DHUANDHAR, at Jabalpur. At Jabalpur, Madhya Pradesh. Jabalpur, Madhya Pradesh. Clear? Narmada flows through trough valleys. T-R-O-U-G-H means rocky surfaces. Narmada flows through trough valleys. T-R-O-U-G-H. Rocky surfaces. Narmada generally flows through the rocky surfaces. Rocky surfaces. And finally fall in a Gulf of Khambhat. It fall in a Gulf of Khambhat. Gulf of Khambhat. K-H-A-M-B-H-A-T. Khambhat, that area. That corner of Gujarat and Maharashtra. Gujarat and Maharashtra, where Narmada falls in Gulf of Khambhat. Yes, Dhirin.
Sir, what is Gulf?
Gulf is a shallow water body. Gulf is a shallow water body which is formed due to the submergence of continental shelf. Abhi continental shelf hoti hai. When all the continents of the world, they came into existence, or the displacement of continents occurred. Disintegration of a Pangaea into the Gondwana and the Angara land. Under such circumstances, the depressions appeared in between of a continents filled with the water, which now presently known as the sea and the oceans. Sea and oceans. So that part of the continent which submerge under the water is known as the Gulf or Bay. They are generally known as the Gulf and Bay because the depth of a sea in such parts is a shallow, less. These are the shallow water bodies, shallow part of a sea and oceans. Clear? Dhiren, clear? So let's continue. Gulf of Khambhat, where the Narmada falls in Arabian Sea. In this part of a Gulf of Khambhat, which is adjacent to the Maharashtra, the largest island is located, which is named as a Alia Bait. Alia Bait. Alia Bait, it is as a largest island which has situated on the estuary of Narmada. Is that clear? On Narmada River, Sardar Sarovar Dam built. The tallest statue of a Sardar Vallabhai Patel, it has laid on that dam which has constructed on a Narmada River. Sardar Sarovar Dam constructed on this river. Sardar Sarovar Dam constructed on Narmada River. Sardar Sarovar Dam constructed on Narmada River, through which canals supplied water to the cotton textile industries of Gujarat. The construction of this dam, it led to the water dispute between Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat. Water dispute. water dispute related with the water of Narmada, because that water required for the cultivation in Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. So the farmers in Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra, they are agitating for procuring their rights of water, which now presently has given to the Gujarat. Now presently the river Narmada's water given to Gujarat. The name of that organization is Narmada Bachao Andolan. Narmada Bachao Andolan, in which farmers, they are protesting to procure their rights of water for cultivation. Clear? Is that clear? For cultivation. This one as the Narmada River. Next is the Tapi River. Tapi River. Yes, Jia.
Sir, the Dar Sarovar Dam provide the water.
Dar Sarovar Dam built on Narmada River to supply water to cotton textiles of Gujarat. Cotton textiles of Gujarat, which raised the dispute in between of Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat. Water dispute. Farmers of Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra agitating to procure their rights of water for cultivation. Water has not supplied to them because all the peninsular rivers are seasonal in nature. During a rainy season, during a monsoons, they are filled with water. And due to that scarcity of water, deficiency of water, that water is mainly required for the cultivation. Yes, Japji Kaur.
Sir, what is Alipet?
That is the largest island which is situated in the Gulf of Khambat on the estuary makes by the Narmada, where the water of Narmada falls in the Arabian Sea. In that part, the largest island is named as Aliabet, Aliabet. Is that clear? Now the second river, Tapi, T-A-P-I, Tapi. The river originates from the river Tapi originates from the Satpura Ranges of Betul district of Madhya Pradesh. It is the second largest westward flowing river. It is the second largest westward flowing river. Which flows parallel to the Narmada in a parallel drainage pattern we discussed. It flows parallel to the Narmada in between of Narmada and Tapi, T-A-P-I, Tapi rivers, Satpura ranges are there, which is known as water divide. Satpura ranges lies in between of Narmada and Tapi is known as water divide. Water divide means when any elevated high area as compared to the mean sea level, any elevated area lies in between of two drainage basins is known as water divide. For example, Satpura lies in between of Satpura lies in between of Narmada and Tapi. One more example is there. Satpura ranges, which lies in between of Narmada and Tapi. Second example, Ambala. Ambala is a district, it is a city of Haryana. Ambala, A-M-B-A-L-A, Ambala lies in between of Satluj and Yamuna. Satluj and Yamuna. Ambala is higher as compared to these two river basins, Yamuna and Satluj. Is that clear? Yamuna and Satluj. The river Tapi receives water. Tapi receives the water to the Purna River. This is as a tributary of a Tapi. Purna River. P-U-R-N-A. Purna River. Tapi receives water through the Purna River. P-U-R-N-A. Purna River. Tapi receives the water from the Purna River. Purna River. The river flows in a rift valley. Tapi also flows through the rocky surfaces or rift valley. Tapi flows through the rift valley as similar to Narmada. And finally, it forms estuary at Gulf of Khambar. Tapi falls in Arabian Sea through Gulf of Khambar. K-H-A-M-B-A-T, Khambar. Tapi fall in Gulf of Khambar through estuary, E-S-T-U-A-R-Y. Clear? Through estuary. Next river is a Sabarmati. Sabarmati. Next river is a Sabarmati. Sabarmati, which originates from Mewar district of Aravali Hills. Sabarmati originates from Mewar Hills of Aravalis in Rajasthan. Aravalis in Rajasthan. It's 320 kilometers long river. 320 kilometers long river. 320 kilometers long river. Tapi originates from Mewar Hills of Aravalis. Mewar Hills of Aravalis. Mewar Hills of Aravalis. It's 320 kilometers long river. Finally, fall in Gulf of Khambar. Length of Tapi as a 724 kilometers long river. Narmada as a 1078 kilometers. Tapi River 724 kilometers. Sabarmati 320 kilometers long river. 320 kilometers long river. Finally falls in Gulf of Khambar. Clear? Next is the Mahi. M-A-H-I. M-A-H-I, M-A-H-I, Mahi. The river Mahi originates from Vindhya Range, and falls in Gulf of Khambar. It's 534 kilometers long river. 534 kilometers long river. 534 kilometers long river. Next one is a Luni, L-U-N-I. Next, last westward flowing river is a Luni, L-U-N-I. The term Luni evolved from the Lavan. Lavan means salt. L-U-N-I, Luni River. Luni, the term evolved from the term, from the word Lavan. This Luni word, it evolved, it derived from the word Lavan, which means salt. This is a salt water river. Luni is a salt water river. Luni is the salt water river. Originates from Aravallis. Luni originates from Aravalli Hills of Rajasthan. Its total length is a 482 kilometers, 482 kilometers long river, 482 kilometers long river. It disappears in Rajasthan. Luni disappears in Rajasthan and re-emerge in Run of Kutch. It means during its course in a India-Pakistan border, it flows underground. Luni flows through the underground. Luni River originates from Aravalli Hills of Rajasthan. It's 482 kilometers long river, disappears in Rajasthan and re-emerge in Run of Kutch of Gujarat. Where it merge in Arabian Sea. It fall in Arabian Sea through the Run of Kutch. Clear? All these are the westward flowing rivers. Any questions regarding it? Westward flowing rivers. First, Narmada, which originates from the Amarkantak Hills. Second one as the Tapi, which originates from Satpura Ranges. Third, Sabarmati, originates from the Mewar Hills of Aravallis. Fourth one as the Mahi, which originates from the Vindhyachal Mountain Ranges. Then the fifth one as a Luni, which originates from Aravallis. Yes, Tanveen?
Please repeat the definition of water divide.
Water divide is an elevated area. Water divide is an elevated area. This is an elevated area or a highland or highland or highland which lies in between of two river basins. Clear, Tanveen? In between of two river basins. Basins means drainage basins, rivers. Example, Satpura lies in between of Narmada and Tapi. Satpura ranges, Second is the Ambala city. The city Ambala of Haryana, which lies in between of Satluj and Yamuna. Clear? Any other doubt? Any other question? Now the eastward flowing rivers. in which refers as a Godavari, eastward flowing rivers, Godavari, eastward flowing rivers, in which refers as the Godavari. Godavari is the largest river of peninsular India. This is the largest river of peninsular India, which is also known as a Dakshina Ganga. Godavari is also known as the Dakshina Ganga. Dakshina Ganga. Because of its length, it is known as a Dakshina Ganga. Its total length is a 1500 kilometer, which originates Trimbak Plateau of Nasik in Maharashtra, near Nasik in Maharashtra. Trimbak Plateau, T-R-I-M-B-A-K, Trimbak Plateau of Nasik district of Maharashtra. The Godavari is often called Vridh Ganga, V-R-I-D-H-A. V-R-I-D-H-A. Godavari, it is also known as a Dakshina Ganga or Vridh Ganga, V-R-I-D-H-A. Vridh Ganga, because of its large size and extent, the important tributaries of Godavari are Vadha, tributaries of Godavari are Vadha, Purna, Vainganga. Next one is a Penganga, Manjra, M-A-N-J-R-A, Manjra, Prahita, all these are the tributaries of Godavari. These are the tributaries of Godavari. Penganga, Vainganga, Vadha, Purna, Manjra, Indravati, etc. are the tributaries of Godavari. Next river, Mahanadi. Next river is a Mahanadi. Mahanadi originates from the Dandakaranya. Mahanadi originates from Dandakaranya. Dandakaranya Hills of Chhattisgarh. Mahanadi originates from Dandkaranya hills of Chhattisgarh. It's 860 kilometers long river. 860 kilometers long river. 860 kilometers long river. Long river makes delta in. It makes delta in north of Chilika Lake. It makes that delta in north of. It makes the delta in north of Chilika Lake. Chilika Lake has narrow depression, has lies in Orissa. It's north of its then. Tapi makes the delta. Hirakud Dam constructed on it. Hirakud Dam constructed on Mahanadi River. Mahanadi River. Clear? Any doubts still there?